Greetings, Mrs. VacLab fans, and today we have another Kirby versus Kirby shootout. On the right, we have a G5 from 1996, and on the left, we have a Kirby 100 Avalir from 2015, 100th anniversary, and they're both kind of in the reddish category. Now, if you're wondering what this Downey Unstoppables are that's sitting in front of the G5, that's what I'm currently using for scent beads inside some of the machines, and it creates kind of a nice scent. I've done various other things for scents. I've done dryer sheets, had good luck. I've also done the Kirby scent tabs, and you do about, oh, I don't know, would you say that's a tablespoon? Okay, tablespoon of those scent beads, and she wanted to make sure that we showed them being sucked up by the G5. So I was like, okay, normally I just put them in the bag, but she figured, oh, let's just put them on the floor and you know, go ahead and put them in the hard way. So that's what we're going to do. Now, you should know that these two machines have several differences other than just, say, their age. Mechanically speaking, this one should probably be around 130 CFM, while the Avalir should probably be around 150 CFM. Every time I measured it, always comes up at 150. So there's about a 20 CFM difference. The nozzles are the same opening, and they both have stiff oblique brush rolls in them, but the transmissions are also different. So there's a couple of gears in a belt that change the transmission boost level. So the Avalir, right, is a slower machine. It has less boost, less power drive, tech drive boost. The G5 on the right has the original amount of boost. So I let her know this, and she said, well, since I'm going to do the second floor, I want the easiest machine to push. So we're going to start out with the G5. So go ahead and put the Avalir away. We'll use that down on the first floor. And go ahead and run the G5, and with all the agitation of the stiff oblique brush roll I put in the G5, let's see how well she's able to vacuum this topical dirt up, because it's a gonna bounce.
It's a gonna bounce.
It's a gonna bounce. Maybe she'll even have to play with the height to try to you know, get them in there, because it obviously it's topical dirt. Pushing nothing.
Like no effort at all.
Thank you.
basement.
all done with the second floor and the G5. So, what'd you think? You haven't used a Kirby in a while. Yeah, two thumbs up.
Piece of cake. Feel no pain. Let's go.
You literally feel like you're not really doing any work. Nope. Maybe you even feel guilty. I know I do with these older G series. Like, I can't possibly be picking anything up. So, okay, time to go down to the first floor and crank up the Avalir. So after a brief explanation with the wife regarding, say, picking up surface dirt and its relative height versus deep cleaning and its relative height, let's see if we have a better pickup than we did a few minutes ago. Carpet triangles. Thank you. Now that's airflow. An Avalir is chasing me. Oh, I see the sun came out again.
Okay.
It was cloudy a minute ago. slide if they fit right there. So, okay, wonderful. So G5, right, the definite older cousin to the newer Avalir, definite difference in CFM to be sure, but certainly an even larger difference in the way that they generally drive because of the gear changes. So tell us what you think. Really, it's older versus new tech drive.
Well, this one here is still fairly easy to move around. It seemed like maybe it suction to the carpet more than this one did. I'm not sure. It felt like it was a little bit more grounded than this one was, but
yeah, 20 more CFM.
So that was really the big difference I noticed, is that it was really sucking down to the carpet, making it just a little bit tighter to push, but mm-hmm. overall it's still fairly easy.
Yeah. And then how about aesthetics?
Well, these are probably two of my favorites because I like this color, and I think this one's just pretty, and yeah, this is cool cutout.
Now, there is an Avalir 2, and I have shown you what it looks like with that wild kind of shocking blue. So you may not remember it, but I know that you've seen it at some point in time. Is that something that you would ever be interested in as a color scheme? What do you think of that shocking blue in the Avalir 2?
Anything blue is great.
Anything, okay, so
two
blue.
Two thumbs for blue.
Right, blue wins no matter what it is.
Make a blue rainbow and I'd be happy.
Okay, so the G5 is effortless to push, still looks pretty good, cleans a little bit less than what the Avalir does. The Avalir then is not too bad to push. Looks great in its new color scheme. I guess that's really probably about it then.
Yep.
Okay. Oh, and of course the transmission is quieter because of the gears as well, so not so much grinding. All right. Thanks so much for watching this VacLab, this Mrs. VacLab series, and stay tuned for more.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.